knew it was going to be mid-80s today. But anyway, appreciate everybody being here. It's a full room, and that's a good sign for Georgia to have this many people here to watch the spring game and to report on it. So thank you for coming. We appreciate that. Georgia won today, which was good. It's so hard to try to judge what kind of a day it was when you're going against, you're going against Georgia, and you're working, your first, second, and sometime your third units, and just a lot of guys getting a lot of reps, and it's hard to look super sharp at that time when, in reality, we're only trying to get one group of 11 on the field at a time on each side of the ball as we go along, so we'll be honing that down as we go. But, minus all the little things that can get you beat, the jumping off sides and a bad snap, those kind of things are frustrating. Even though it's spring, we're practice 13 right now. We should be doing a little bit better in that regard. But when things were executed properly offensively, it was pretty to watch, no doubt. And defensively, I thought the guys, for the most part, played well together as a unit, tackled well, had some good balls batted down at the line of scrimmage. A couple plays might have been a sack. One or two, I think I'd have called a sack if I was the official, but we did ask them to let them play as much as possible, with the quarterbacks not being live. So I think that we got out of it what we needed. It's one of those days where until you watch the film, you can't really judge who did what to a certain degree. A lot of things happened for me too, working from the sideline up to the radio and TV booth and missing some things along the way. So I'll do the best I can to answer any questions you have, and we'll all get out of this sweat box.
Mark, the quarterbacks, they had a lot of pressure on them at times. How would you evaluate each one's performance?
Right. Well, there's going to be pressure on the quarterback. There's going to be, in the game, the pocket's going to get tight on them at times, and so now you've got to make good decisions by throwing the ball away, hitting the check down, or even taking a sack from time to time. And a couple times they took sacks, and sometimes that's the best decision made. You can't really control your rush, but what you have to do is trust your protection every time. Even if you get sacked three times in a row, you got to drop back believing that your protection is going to be there. And it wasn't that bad. I'm not saying that, but in the mentality of the quarterback and how we teach them, you must trust your protection every time. Because once you decide you're going to start watching them rush and try to decide if it's good enough protection to stand in there, you just make too many mistakes, and you will get a bunch of sacks and make a bunch of bad decisions. But overall, talking about Bryce, for me to sit here and grade him, like I said, I've missed a bunch of plays as I was going up and down stairs. He did make some nice plays. I think he, overall, in the spring, I can probably talk in more generalities of the spring. I think he's done a very good job of studying what to do, getting us in the right protections, getting us in the right hot and side adjustment situations. I think he's been really pretty accurate throughout the spring football practices to this point. Fatone has also been a guy that has worked extremely hard to get a comfort level with everything that Coach Shotty's trying to teach him. And I think he got better and better as the spring went along. Jacob ran more reps with the 2 and 3 units, but you can see his arm talent, you can see his ability. And I think this summer is going to be crucially important for him. All of them, really, but I think the more he gets comfortable with the system, the better he'll compete. But I think it's still a race. I don't think there's any question that it's going to go through the summer and fall before we make a decision on who that guy is to start the first ball game.